Well, Democrats Kevin Kamenetz and Joe Bartenfelder are now using the TV airwaves as a way to get their message out to voters.
And both are making some pretty strong claims. I-Team reporter David Collins put them to the test. He joins us in the studio with the results of our latest Commitment 2010 fact check. David?
Stan, Kevin Kamenetz wants you to believe he single-handedly got the county to install air conditioning at a local school, and that he has the backing of the FOP. Plus, he put more police in your neighborhood. Joe Bartenfelder suggests he's Superman, able to tend to his family farm and the people's business. He also wants you to believe he single-handedly secured record state funding for school construction.
My kids attended Ridgely Middle School, but for years we had a problem. There was no air conditioning, and no one would listen, until we met with Kevin Kamenetz. Unlike most politicians, Kevin didn't make excuses. He went to work. He got the county to install a new air conditioning system.
This is true, but Kamenetz did not do this alone. Ridgely Middle School PTA gives credit to Kamenetz and his opponent, Councilman Joe Bartenfelder. They also credit Councilman John Olszewski, Councilman Brian McIntyre, as well as State Senator Jim Brochin, State Delegate Susan Allman, Delegate Bill Frank, and Delegate Steve Lafferty. Ridgely Middle PTA established the Ridgely Climate Committee, which monitored school temperatures, and the organization generated extensive media coverage of the issue. Earlier this year, Baltimore County Executive Jim Smith directed the school system to install air conditioning in 2 middle and 7 elementary schools, including Ridgely Middle, which had already been prepped for air conditioning.
Now Kevin's running for county executive with a plan to bring more resources to every county school based on what that school needs, not what some bureaucrat wants.
This is true. Kamenetz plans to create a grassroots system providing each school, its principal, and PTA an opportunity to present its needs directly to the superintendent's office. The Kamenetz campaign recently released another ad. This one regards crime fighting.
He's put more police in our neighborhoods.
This is true, but in reality, he helped to secure funding simply by voting in favor of the county budget.
And Kevin wrote the law, putting video cameras in our shopping center.
This is true. Kamenetz wrote and shepherded the law through council following the 2005 murder of St. Paul School Dean William Bassett at Towson Center.
Putting video cameras in our shopping centers, reducing violent crime by 31%.
This is true, according to the Baltimore County Police Department. It analyzed crime stats of 42 of 100 shopping areas where cameras are being used. Crime stats in 07, 08, and 09 were compared with those in 04, 05, and 06. Joe Bartenfelder recently released his first TV ad.
Joe Bartenfelder secured record state funding for school construction and improvement.
This is true, but in reality, he helped to secure funding simply by voting in favor of the county budget.
And Joe voted against his own pay raise.
This is true, but in his 16-year council career, Bartenfelder voted in favor of a pay hike twice. In 2005, he voted against one. But the action was symbolic. Four of his colleagues had already voted in support, making the measure a done deal, and Bartenfelder accepted the pay increase.
Although the Bartenfelder ad leaves the impression he's not going negative right out of the gate, one county political observer says the very last line stating he's an honest Joe is a slight against Kamenetz, suggesting you can't believe what he says on the campaign trail. Meanwhile, Kamenetz is quoted online acknowledging it would be difficult to attribute specific crime reductions to specific initiatives. We asked the county police department for a list of the shopping centers it analyzed and a breakdown of the crime stats. Reporting live from the studio, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.